Ah, I'm glad to see you made it back in one piece. So, what have you learned? Anything? What? Well, that sounds ghastly. To think that my own brother would be capable of such a thing. We must move quickly. Did you find any evidence? I'll need something concrete if I'm to convince the Hlaalu trade barons to intercede. Well done. I have a final task for you, if you're willing. I must take this to the trade baron, Councillor Ryveth. He's staying at the Balmora Inn. Alas, Benna has many contacts in town. If he hears that I'm meeting Ryveth, he may try to flee. Travel to the Rhythan Manor House and detain Benna. Once I've explained manners to Ryveth, he'll send Hlaalu constables to collect my brother. After this, I'll ask nothing more of you. You have my word. Not long. He tends to be brusque. Once I've explained the situation, he'll waste no time bringing Benna in for questioning. It will be brief, I assure you. They will punish him. Severely. He'll definitely lose his share of the estate and the ebony mine. He may even lose his life. In either case, I'll have to bear the weight of our family assets alone. That the men I worked tirelessly to hire were being used as fodder for some vile experiment? Absolutely not. It's appalling. Why would I have sent you to discover what was going on if I already knew? Yes, I hired him at my brother's insistence. Something about valuable books and scrolls found in the shrine. We planned to sell them off once Gavros translated them. That's what I thought, anyway. Wait, Gavros is still alive? I see. That is unfortunate. But I suppose that's the risk you take when you start brewing foul decoctions and poisoning innocent miners.
To tie up loose ends.
Malareth armor. What a swit. I'm going to... You don't appear to be holding my drink, so I'm sure I have no interest in you. Off with you. I am. Young Mahler and I were talking about the sudden success of his mining enterprise, built on some irregularities that I'd prefer not to discuss. Not that it's any of your business. Who are you? Why are you meddling in Tlalu business? My, my. This is damning. Dear Mahler tried to hang this whole business around his brother's neck. And yours. A prudent, albeit sloppy affair. House Tlalu can ill afford such a scandal, and I hate to be lied to. Kill Mahler, and I will reward you. What would I do with him? Chain him to a post? His life no longer serves the house's interests. I don't expect an outlander to understand, but this needs to be done. Honestly, I doubt he'll give you a choice in the matter. His city residence, I expect, just across the river. Do be quick about this. I'm anxious to be done with the Brothers Rethan. No. What scroll? Don't tell me there's more to this fetching disaster. Does it now? Listen carefully. Don't breathe a word of this to anyone else. If Mahler has this formula on him, bring it to me. The reward will be significant. We cannot let this get out, and we cannot let it fall into the wrong hands. By the three, what a mess. I'll put some of my oathmen on it. Oathmen I can trust. If we can clear out the riffraff, it might be salvageable. If not, we'll simply collapse the thing. Better to bury it than let some fool stumble upon Marla's folly.
Thank you.
finish this myself.
Quietly now. Is it finished?
Well then, this unfortunate little tale comes to an end. I've already dispatched some of my best agents to clean up Rethun Manor. We'll tend to Marla's apartment and the mine next. Well done. Now, what of this mysterious scroll? Excellent. Best hand it over to me. Something so dangerous should not fall into the wrong hands. House Flalu can keep it safe, or destroy it if we deem it necessary. This will earn you some favor with our house. I'll even double your pay. You've proven to be a reliable assistant. House Flalu values reliability. I would say it's been a pleasure, but this whole affair has left me with quite a headache. Still, I may call upon you again in the future. Here, double pay as promised.
The fire's warm.
castle, Alu.
You killed one of my gang, Swit. No writ will protect you from us.
Feeling left out? I'm sure I can procure a writ for each of you.
That's it! Kill the Morag! I need aid!
News getting muddled. I had that situation under control. Just needed them to make the first hostile move. Still, I cleaned enough blood off my axes for one day, so thanks for lending a hand.
Were you? Was it Melissa?
I told her I'd close out my tab after I completed another contract. That woman has the patience of an anxious Nyx. Well, tell her I'm good for it. I'll stop by and we can conclude our business cordially.
Veya?
The new apprentice? Now why in Oblivion do you care about Veya?
Are you now? And why do you want to do that? Never mind, I don't really care. I was asked to pass along some notes, but I'm not really the messenger type. I suggest you talk to Veya's mentor. Last I heard, she had a job in the Western Ruins.
Make sure you don't anger Veya's mentor, or even look at her the wrong way. She's grown surprisingly protective of that young woman, and if she thinks you pose a danger... Besides, I'd hate to see you wind up on the wrong end of one of our writs.
You know the usual buyer's remorse. I see a lot of that in my line of work. Turns out, I'd kill a bad man who did bad things. The writ was legal and above board. Unfortunately, his brother didn't see it that way and was looking for revenge.
Oh, you make it sound so obscene. Still, that's pretty much an accurate description. But it's not like I work for the Dark Brotherhood or anything. I don't kill anyone without a sanctioned writ. Keeps the great houses in line. It's a calling.
I'd rather not. She's particular about her secrets, and I don't want to get on a bad side.
You should keep that in mind, too, if you plan to continue on this course. Veya's mentor usually sticks to the rules, but...
Thank you.
look! A Dwemer gear. It's in remarkably good condition.
Yes, wonderful. I'll mark it down.
And here, another. Could these have fallen off the ruins?
Yes, that is peculiar.
Is something the matter, dear? You seem distracted today.
Oh, nothing's the matter. I'm just... I'm nervous.
Whatever for? If anything attacks us, I'll protect you.
I'm not nervous about an attack, Bravora. Right. It's just...
Well, it tells on me.
There's no
the
good way to say
of the great houses.
To say what?
Marry me.
Are you serious?
That's not the response I hoped for.
Gilan, of course I'll marry you. I love you. I just expected something more dramatic.
Well, I planned to propose at the Falls, but today we didn't go to the Falls. I had to improvise.
And this is why you've been so nervous.
Yes. Wait. Did you just agree to marry me?
Yes, Gilan. A dozen times yes. My dear, distracted, adorable archivist, I will marry you.
That's wonderful!
Isn't it?
Oh, Bravora, you won't regret this. You are the stars to my sky.
Did you just come up with that?
Well, no. I've been saving it for the right time.
Thank you.
with you too? This is ridiculous.
I'm sorry, Telenra, but my wife insists we try a real mage.
What do you want?
Someone in need? Well?
Help! Someone! Please help! Please help! You must help! Bandits! They attacked my father's wagon on the roads to Sauron! They're stealing everything we own! My father's a proud Mer. They may kill him! You have to help us!
A wanted criminal.
Such displeasure and disappointment. Nothing works, even though every calculation is precise. Now an interruption. How infuriating. Wait, wait. Sometimes the great gear turns from frustration to opportunity. Divine energy. I'll have you know I participated in Lord Sothesil's 9 analyses of the Exalted Enigmas. But we have more important matters. I'm about to determine the correlation between color and time. And I could use another set of hands. A reciprocal exchange. Interesting, yes. I can see the benefits of such an arrangement. Very well. Just activate the crystals in the proper sequence while I modulate the energy flow. Less chance of an explosion that way. Such a waste repeating words. Activate the crystals in the proper order. It's all about colors, like a rainbow. Make a mistake and reset the mechanism using that lever, unless it explodes. You'd be surprised how often that happens. Reset the mechanism and try again. Activated but not in the proper sequence. Try again. Reset the mechanism and try again. A good start. Keep going. Smoke instead of light. Not the reaction I was hoping for. A good start. Keep going. So far, so good. Close, very close. One more to go. Yes, I love it when the gears align. Perfect. Such are the benefits of an extra set of appendages. The energy flows freely and without disruption, allowing the rods and the pistons to align in a most pleasing manner. Thank you. Now, why do you want to know about divine energy? Scent? How intriguing. I was just thinking about my former master, Sothesil, and the experiments we conducted. He desperately sought to understand the power he and his companions attained, especially whether or not that power was temporary. Not while I assisted him. He had a tool that he used to drain away minute bits of his own divine energy to store and study. Could extract it and return it as he saw fit. Not sure what became of the tool, but here are my notes from those days. More questions? Well, Lord Sothesil attributed curiosity to intellectual superiority. Suppose I should do the same. Ask, and I will attempt to tighten the cogs. Odd question. Is a hammer a weapon?
A saw? A Dwemer spring spanner? No, it was just a tool. A device crafted by Seth Asil to aid in his endless experiments. I suppose I could imagine ways to modify the device, but for what reason? Haven't a clue. Tools have a way of wandering off when you don't stay vigilant. Had a guava used to swallow tools when I wasn't looking. Glowed for a month until the enchantment dissipated and the tool passed. Should have heard the screams. I was his apprentice, but that was years ago. Spent time working in the Clockwork City. That's what I learned about energy transference, Dwemer engineering, mechanical symmetry. Made me the Dark Elf I am today. I have a question. Who sent you? The Arch-Canon? Lord Vivek's High Priest? Suddenly the gears align. I can think of a number of reasons that Alman V would want to know about C and his tools, but some doors just shouldn't be opened. He's the father of mysteries, and the architect of time, one of the Tribunal, the three living gods of the Dark Elves. Creates all sorts of helpful and intriguing devices, like the Clockwork City. I haven't seen my old master. It's a wonder and a miracle. All brass tunnels, glass domes, and giant gears. He was inspired by the work of the Dwemer. But the Clockwork City is pure Seth Asil. He made it to forge the future and reshape the world. I learned a lot there.
Outlander, over here!
This requires a considerable amount of effort, so just listen. We have a problem here. Return to my office immediately.
Thank you. I'm down on my luck. Help me out.
At last. Did you see what's happening outside? Red Mountain rumbles louder and more frequently. The sky grows dark, and worst of all, the people are beginning to notice. Soon I'll have to muster the Ordinators to keep them from the palace doors. In part, Lord Vivek is... not well. I won't allow his followers to see him in this state. He continues to lose energy, and it's becoming difficult for him to maintain the realm in his usual fashion. Now, what did your investigations uncover? I'll review these documents and present your findings to Lord Vivek. I was against bringing you into this investigation, but I was wrong. Thank you for aiding us. You should go see Lord Vivek now. He's been asking about you. I'll be along shortly. Very well. Tell me what you learned at each of the locations. And let's see what conclusions we can come to. Berelzar faithfully served Sothis Seal. He's as loyal to the Tribunal as I am. He would never intentionally harm Lord Vivek. But that tool he mentioned... Perhaps one of the priests Vivek sent away could search the temple archives for more information. Lord Vivek doesn't want his followers to see him in such a weakened state. Only you, Canon Levuel, and myself are permitted into his palace now. Speaking of the palace, Lord Vivek wants to see you when we're done here. So your notes say, and this Saren assisted you. Interesting. Most Ashlanders want nothing to do with the Tribunal. Even so, they rarely become aggressive. I'd say this Chodala bears watching. If we can spare it, I'll send an armiger to Alderaan. Interesting theory. Perhaps Chodala's staff can steal Vivek's energy. But I have a hard time imagining how an Ashlander could accomplish such a feat. Lord Vivek said the draining has grown more intense since you left. It doesn't look well. From what you discovered, I dare say there may be a correlation between the Nicotic Relic and the tool Berelzar mentioned. And it seems the Ashlander thieves are connected to Chodala. Your evidence points to a clear conclusion. So it appears. Lord Vivek's doing his best not to complain, but I can see how much the draining of his energy has cost him. Just seeing you again should improve his mood considerably. And the progress you made with your investigations, outstanding.
Halt, Fett! I think we should execute criminals on sight. But my captain won't allow it. He wants your bounty. Fine. Now get your stink away from me.
I demand you make way and let me see Lord Vivek!
Lord Vivek isn't receiving visitors today.
My lord, please let me send for aid. Perhaps one of the healers can help you.
Pain is best tolerated in private. As I have written in the 37th ballad.
There must be something I can do.
You can call the Archcanon. He should hear the news our friend brings us. The river drains into the sea. As my divinity flows out of me. Need some work. As you can see, I continue to lose energy, It has made me somewhat agitated. Have you made any progress toward discovering the source of my discomfort? An Ashlander? That seems unlikely, but I trust your instincts. We need to find out more about this Chodala and the ancient enemy that aids him. Take this. Another token of my appreciation. And look, here comes the Archcannon now.
My lord, the Outlander may have actually discovered something. After further examination of the documents you brought back, I have to agree with your assessment. The Ashlander Chodala has somehow siphoned divine energy away from Lord Vivek. Not exactly. But now that we know that the affliction isn't natural, we can work toward a solution, one that probably involves Chodala's staff. How the Ashlander got his hands on Sothisil's tool and turned it into a weapon is beyond me. Eventually, but we need to be cautious. If Chordala is as respected as you say, attacking him would start a war we can't afford to partake in. Go to Aldrin and talk to his sister, Saren. I don't trust her. Get to Aldrin and locate Saren. She needs to tell us more about Chordala and then help us acquire his staff. Without it, we can't restore Vivek. Meanwhile, I need to placate the populace. The people grow concerned over Vivek's continuing isolation. Didn't we cover this? If we knew for certain, we wouldn't be sending you to make a deal with the Heretic. Everything you uncovered suggests the staff and Sotha Sill's missing tool are one and the same, and it's obviously connected to Chordala's newfound powers. Bring it back here so I can study it. The solution resides in the staff. Experience, Outlander. Experience. I have seen the Dunmer rage against the gods at the least provocation. When they realize that Vivek is ill, that his powers are failing, they'll weep and gnash their teeth like frightened children. The people don't handle the infirmities of their deities very well, especially when those infirmities could foreshadow Red Mountain's eruption or portend the moonlets fall from the sky. Once such fear ignites, it spreads like wildfire. They try not to think about them at all. The Ashlanders are savages. They refuse to acknowledge the supremacy of Lord Vivek in the Tribunal, instead putting their faith in the despicable Daedra. They're heretics, pure and simple. The Ashlanders hold to superstitions the way Quama protect their eggs. If they really considered Chordala to be the Nereverin, then any action you take against him will enrage the tribes. Talk to Saren and see if she can suggest an alternative course.
No words for apologies. Seek.
You have a look about you, some sort of quality that's rare to find. And trust me, I'm never wrong about these sort of things. Can I interest you in a room at the local inn? Actually, wait, that came out wrong. Look, empty. Oh, sure. Excellent. You hope the room is to your... Oh, what a relief. Hope the room is to your liking. Hope the room is... Nope, just make yourself at home. Spruce things up a bit. Honestly, I can't wait to see how you arrange the place. Hopefully you'll end up... Oh, what a relief. I own this.
Yourself.
honor and service.
Welcome to the Guild Hall, Knowledge Seeker. What brings you here today?
We're book hunters of a sort. We seek out new information, capture it in our libraries, and make copies for distribution across Tamriel. The Guild doesn't care about battlefields or boundaries, just knowledge and the acquisition of new tomes.
We provide training in unique spells and abilities only available to members. And from time to time, projects crop up for those with an adventuresome spirit. You may end up working with the Guildmaster himself.
Excellent. You are now a student of the Mages Guild.
If you came for craft, you must be here to learn the craft. I'm authorized to train and certify provisioners, alchemists, and enchanters. If this interests you, we should begin immediately. Certainly. Please specify. Food and drink. Anything that warms the belly, reinvigorating body and mind. If you choose to learn this art, I will impart the culinary knowledge I acquired over the course of decades. Potions of all kinds. The subtle art of mixing reagents can produce rather unsubtle effects. Glyphs to empower weapons, armor, and jewelry with magical properties. I can teach you how to wreath your axe with flames, or give cloth robes the strength of iron. I suppose I should mention Milaneth. She certifies blacksmiths, clothiers, and woodworkers. If you're into that sort of thing. But that's uncharitable of me. She's a true master of the material crafts. Good. We should begin while... There is much more I can teach you. Roast pig is an easy recipe to learn, but provisioners are only as good as their ingredients. The fuel barrel should cause...
Thank you. Thank you. Leave me, Outlander. Let me die in the shame I've brought to Malekith. Defeated by a lone warrior. Oh, Malekith will laugh at our incompetence. An assassin. Probably a Morag Tongue. She tracked our leader here. But she... she doesn't know. We set a trap inside the ruins.
She's just one woman! Get inside the ruins and stop her! Let the assassin come. I'm tired of running and she doesn't fright me.
At least you sure aren't dressed like one. You're walking into a dangerous place, Hero. You must be here for a reason. Questions? I don't have time for questions. I have a writ to complete. Look, I can't keep these evil cultists waiting. You want to talk? Find me after I finish this job.
Thank you.
Come out, little assassin! Or is the Morath Khan too scared to meet the power of the snake face to face?
Excuse me, hero. I have to see an orc about a writ.
Don't kill me. I didn't mean to interfere with House Tovani's plans. I made a mistake.
A mistake? Well, that explains everything. I'll just let the Tovani know. I'm sure Mage Valian will understand.
Oh, that's a relief. I thought for sure you were going to kill me.
I am. Ugh, I hate when my leathers get wet. And this is a new outfit, too. Ah, well. I suppose we ought to discuss what you're doing here. You're obviously not one of the Malakath cultists, so I have one question. Why the tusk are you following me, and why shouldn't I just kill you and be done with it? Yes, that was two questions, and an orc curse, and a threat. It's been a long day. Oh, that's not what I expected. But you can just turn around and leave. You're not going to find her. Vaya's going through a difficult time right now, and the last thing she needs is some House Redoran lackey adding to her pain and confusion. Really? Is that what old man Eris told you? And did he tell you about Vaya's brother? About how House Redoran exiled their favorite son? No? I didn't think so. Vaya needs answers and I promise to help her.
so walk away while you still can. Outsiders? Is her father really that desperate? Look, tell Eris that Bea's safe and you'll see her soon, but no more outsiders. If my organization gets skittish, they'll return to the shadows and take Bea with them. We'll only deal with you. Well, it's not exactly a lie, and I don't want things to get out of hand. I'll arrange a meeting, provided Bea agrees. You let Eris know she's safe. Get him to stop hiring freelancers before someone gets hurt. I'll send word when we're ready. That was Peritree in motion. Not only is my organization getting choice assignments again, but we're starting to recover some of our prestige. Specifically, these Malakath cultists interfered with House Telvanni, so they had to be dealt with. Oh, him? No one special. Just the leader of this particular band of mad cultists. His name was on the writ, so I had to end him. It's what I do, after all, and I do it. So, I suppose if you're in for a sliver, you might as well be in for the log. I'm with the Morog Tong, and what you witnessed was a legal murder. According to my writ, the orc had to die. So, I killed him. Now, if you don't mind, I need to get back to Bea. Bea and I have a history. A brother, too. They were good kids. Liked to watch me train. Now I feel responsible for her. When she came to me looking for help and asked to join the Morog Tong, who was I to refuse? That was her decision, not mine. Bea is good with a blade and tracks like a Nord Ranger. She's a natural at this, and it gives me a chance to keep an eye on her. So now I'm her mentor and she's my apprentice. I wouldn't have it any other way. That was Peritree in motion. Not only is my organization getting choice assignments again, but we're starting to recover some of our prestige. Specifically, these Malakath cultists interfered with House Telvanni, so they had to be dealt with.
Can I help you?
I'm surprised to see you back here, but I'm also relieved. Does this mean you have news about my daughter? Is she safe? Is she... Vaya? Joined that cult of assassins? I was afraid she'd... She... As you say. When next you...
Anything I can do for you?
Well, look at that. Now you said I'd find you here. And did I mention how much I hate being a messenger? Makes me wish I had a writ so I could kill something. Anyway, now you wants to talk to you. Said you'd know what it was all about. Here. This should explain everything, sort of. It's a map.
We changed look.
Never had to use a map before. Look, I know you're helping Counselor M.
What are you?
Then you understand?
Well, look.
As I understand...
What are you implying?
Well, not...
Well, look...
The other... As I understand...
What are you implying?
What do you want?
sorry about all the...
It's a travesty the criminals walk. Now get lost, scum.
Still alive, I see.
I can get to the swamp. Oh, don't think. It's not like...
Anything's possible. Danger's a relative term.